What we have here is commonly known as a organized riot. And this first guy, when I first met Chris Christopherson, he was really shy. In a loud sort of way, you know. And I think he's still just about the same old hoss. Right here he is, Chris Christopherson.
Well, thank you, Willie. Listen, the thing that was so important about Sue's place in the Boar's Nest for people like me and Vince and all of us was it was the only place that we had to show what we were doing to an audience that mattered and people whose opinions we respected, you know. And if it hadn't been for that place, that was the only thing we had to the only positive feedback I had for like 4 years. I'd have gone before I ever wrote a song that was worth a lick, you know. This is one of them that I wrote back then. He said humbly, as I woke up Sunday morning with no way to hold my head that didn't hurt. The beer I had for breakfast wasn't bad, so I had one more for dessert. George looks away at me. Then I fumbled through my closet for my clothes and found my cleaning's dirty shirt. I washed my face and combed my hair, stumbled down the stairs to meet the day. I'd smoked so much the night before, my mouth was like an ashtray I'd been licking. That's the way I wrote it. I lit my first and watched a small kid cussing at a can that he was kicking. Then I crossed the empty street, caught the Sunday smell of someone frying chicken. And it took me back to something that I'd lost somehow, somewhere along the way. On the Sunday morning sidewalk. What a sorry looking bunch. Wishing, Lord, that I was stoned. There's something in a Sunday makes a body feel alone.
There's a word.
It's getting depressing. There ain't nothing short of dying half as lonesome as the sound. On the sleeping city sidewalks, Sunday morning coming down.
Thank you. Yeah. One of the oldest and dearest friends that Sue Brewer ever had, I'm sure, was Webb Pierce. And I imagine Webb's got a million stories that he could tell us, but I'm just going to turn it over to you.
I know a lot of times I'd be lonely, you know. And I'd go up there and visit with her at a place, and I knew I'd get to see maybe George Jones or Waylon Jennings or Willie Nelson. Hey, you were too young, Hank. I don't know if you were there many times.
Kilgore took my place.
Merle Kilgore, yeah. And in fact, me and Merle wrote a song up there one night. He wrote it, and I cut him in on it. Anyway, every once in a while, Sue would say, "Hey, we got to lighten up the place. That it's about time to have the national anthem for the Boar's Nest." So I'd sing this song. There stands the glass that will ease all my pain, that will settle my brain. brother, I'm on my way. While I'm wondering where you are tonight, and I'm wondering if you are all right, I wonder if you think of me in my misery. There stands the glass, fill her up to the brim, until my troubles grow dim. It's my first one today. How about a little picking, Willie? That's enough to spur a fella on. I'm wondering where you are tonight. I'm wondering if you are all right. I wonder if you think of me in my misery. You did hear spur, didn't you?
Yes, I did.
There stands the glass. Oh, fill it up to the brim. Until my troubles grow dim. It's my first one to take.
That's great. That's great. This next guy was as much a fixture at Sue Brewer's house as a couch or a chair. In fact, he was skinny back then, and we used to sit on him. Mac Vickery.
Amen. God bless you, buddy. Thank you, brother. Speaking of skinny, sometimes were and sometimes wasn't. Thank God for the skinny times, because that makes the fat ones look better. Streak of lean, streak of fat, skinny gums on a streak of that. I want to thank you for having me on this song. I had a gal in Cedar Town, Georgia. I used to walk nearly 3 miles of Georgia Swamp, Dakota.
Hey.
She never had much, just a sharecropper's daughter. I married her and took her down New Orleans. I rent a little home in the South French Quarter. Sweet honky tonk wine. I know you didn't record that, Waylon, but Mickey did. So did Jerry Lee. Somebody had to show Mickey how to sing. Thank you, Mickey. For putting it in the Urban Cowboy movie. You can cut that part out if you want to. Honky tonk wine. Why don't you know that it keeps me out of my M-I-N-D mind, Lord. All she's left behind is a little bit of sweet. $1.28, get you 7-Eleven store. Honky tonk wine.